Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to perform the hands-on of feature scaling. We will cover hands-on by using the scikit-learn library, where I am going to use the min-max scaler, standard scaler and robust scaler. In today's video, I am going to only cover the first two, min-max scaler and standard scaler. In our next video, I will cover the robust scaler. So without wasting any time, let's start. In our last video, we have discussed what is the normalization and what is the standardization. So today I am going to tell you which technique we should use to perform the feature scaling, whether we should use normalization or standardization. If I will talk about the in a general scenario, like in a real world type of the problem, so nobody can tell you that you can always use the normalization for this data or standardization for this particular data, because in the real world all data are different in each project, so nobody is gonna tell you about that. So what we normally use to perform, we perform both the technique, and which technique will provide you better accuracy or better result, that technique be used to consider. So but there are some scenarios, like if your data is normally distributed, let's you have some feature. So what you can do, you can visualize your data features, and if your features is normally distributed, like mean is your 0 and standard deviation is equal to 1, then you can perform the standardization. Otherwise you can perform the normalization, but I would always suggest you perform both the technique. This technique will provide you better accuracy or the evaluation matrix. That technique you can consider for your machine learning model building. And also, this is very important point, as I mentioned here, once we will perform the feature scaling, there will be some data leakage. So what things we have to consider, let's you are going to create a one machine learning model. So what we used to perform, first we take the data, this is your data, then we do the feature scaling, then after that we do the test and train split, then that data we use for our training purpose. But this is completely wrong thing. So what we used to do, first once you have a data, first you have to do the train test split, then after that you have to perform the feature scaling. So if you follow this approach, you will not get the data leakage. Data leakage is that, leakage means you are transferring the same type of the information into the test data. It means once you train your model, okay, and after that once you evaluate your model with the test data, this is your train data, you train your model here, after that you test the model with the help of test data. So what happens, once you do the train and test split, after the feature scaling, what happens, same type of the pattern can transfer into the test data. So what we used to get, we used to get good accuracy once we evaluate our model with the help of test data, and once we deploy that model over the production, our model gets some unknown data, that data which has never been available in your training. So what happened, your model will not perform better, so it will provide you the wrong prediction. So that's why what we used to perform, first we do the train and test split, then after that we used to perform the feature engineering and feature scaling, all these techniques. I will cover the data leakage in a separate video. You can follow that video to understand the data leakage. So let's start the hands-on. So first I am going to import the required libraries. Here I am going to import the our data set. If you see here, right, this is our data set. So this data set, what I am going to do, I am going to perform the first train and test split. So I am just separating the X and Y here. Then after that you can see the shape of the data, 15 rows and 2 columns we have. in the x, and by we have 15 rows and 0 column. It means that we have to predict. I am going to perform the train test split. For that, I am going to import the train test split class from the model selection module. After that, I am going to do the train test split. Here we can get the split data. You can see 10 and 5. 10 rows in your train and 5 rows in your test data. Here what I am going to do, I am going to copy this particular train data in the new variable data frame experience, taking this for the naming purpose. You can see this is our data. So this data we will use for our feature scaling. So how we used to perform, let's check. This is your test data. So what first we will do, we are going to use first min max scaler. How the min max scaler work? In the min max scaler, we have like 0 and 1. It means all the data lie between 0 and 1. Let's see whether our data lie between 0 and 1 or not. You can see I am going to import the min max scaler class from the pre-processing module. What I am going to do, first I am going to create the object min max scaler. This is object. Now what I am going to do, I am going to fit our training data here. You can see, right? Then once we fit our training data, on top of that I am going to use the transform where I am going to use our training data. It means this is like your object and fit, and this we will use to transform our training data, and same thing I am gonna use to transform our test data, right? Same thing you can perform to avoid the data leakage. Let's see. Now our data has been transformed. You can see all the data lie between 0 and 1. Now here what I am going to do, I am going to use this object and fit scaler to transform our test data. You can see here min max scale, this one min max scale, you can see. Then going to transform the test data here, same thing, and after converting this data into a data frame, because the output will be your array. So that's why I'm going to create one data frame just for our understanding. Now you can clearly see that this is our your transform data, and all the data lie between 0 and 1. So this way you can perform the feature scaling with the help of min max scaler. Now I am going to visualize this data. For that I am going to use the scatter plot from the matplotlib. Here what I am going to use, I am going to use this particular our new, it means this transform data, this one, this data frame, right? This data frame. Then what I am going to do, I am going to use the plot and then scatter method from this data frame, and these are the values which you can get with the help of help section. Here I am going to mention the x is equal to experience, x is your experience and y is your salary, and marker I am going to use this, and label I am going to use the after scaling, and this is your before scaling. So this way we can visualize our data. You can see here, you can see here, this is your before scaling. It means red dot is your before scaling and this is your after scaling. So now you can see that all the data lie between 0 and 1. Like this is your scatter plot. If you see the value of x, x is your experience. So all the experience value lie between 0 and 1, right? So corresponding we get the salary, and salary also lie between 0 and 1. If you see here, all these red point data are plotted with the help of before scaling, and these were plotted with the help of after scaling, right? So after scaling data should come under the 0 and 1, and same thing we are getting. Now I am going to explain the standard scaler, how we can use that. For that I am going to import the standard scaler class from the pre-processing module of the scikit-learn. So what you can do, first you can create the object, then you can perform the fit, and that fit method you can use to transform your train data as well as your test data. But here what I am going to do, I am going to just analyze the data. That's why I am using the fit and transform, but in real world we don't use that. We use standard scaler then fit, that particular that scalar module we use to scale our data for train and test. If you see, all the data has been transformed with the help of standard scalar, and here data should have mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation is equal to 1, right? In the standardization we have mu is equal to 0 and standard deviation is equal to 1, right? So what I am going to do, I am going to print these value, mean and standard deviation. If you see here, from the new data frame, this new data frame, let's check what value we get. We are getting 0 and 1 here. It means all the data are distributed accordingly. Now I am going to visualize these things, like before scaling and after scaling, same code which we used during the min max scaler, same code, just change the data frame. Here you can see before scaling is your star red, mark in the red color. This is your before scaling. Now data has been transformed and distributed, where mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation is equal to 1. But the problem with the standardization is that if we have an outlier in our data, in that case it doesn't perform well. So that's why what we do, we use the robust scaler. That I will cover in our next video. I hope this video will be helpful to all of you. I hope you will like this video. If you will like this video, please share this video with your friends and colleagues, and also subscribe my channel. Thank you.